Indicators of compromise, or IoCs, are data that indicate potential malicious activity in a network or computer system. They're an essential feature of any endpoint protection solution, like Microsoft Defender for Endpoint, which provides multiple ways to add and manage IoCs. I'll demonstrate those options in this video and describe why you might choose one over another. Microsoft uses the same list of IoCs in multiple places, but you only create them once. To get a sense of how this works, look at the article titled "Create Indicators" on Microsoft Docs. First, the Cloud Detection Engine in Defender for Endpoint constantly scans data for matching IoCs and acts based on the settings you specify when you create them. Second, Microsoft Defender Antivirus honors the same list of IoCs and takes the appropriate action, like blocking the file when an IoC is discovered. And last, the Automated Investigation and Remediation Engine uses the same IoCs to ignore an allowed file or act on one that should be blocked during an automated investigation. Now that you know how Defender for Endpoint uses IoCs, let's create some. That's next. One method to add an IoC in Defender for Endpoint is by manually creating it. To do that in Microsoft 365 Defender, in Settings, select Endpoints, followed by Indicators. There are different types of IoCs you can add, including file hashes, IP addresses, URLs and domains, and certificates. For this example, I'll manually add a file hash indicator by selecting Add Item. In File Hash, I'll paste the file hash that I previously copied to the clipboard. Then, I could pick an expiration date for this indicator. For example, you could create a temporary IoC while you continue an investigation, but I'll just leave it to never expire. On the next page, I can choose what happens when Defender for Endpoint finds this hash. I can allow or audit the file without blocking it, warn users with a prompt they can bypass, block the file, or block and remediate it. I'll select Audit and complete the information that will appear in the alert. This is just a demo, so in Alert Severity, I'll select Informational, and in Category, I'll select Malware. A description is also required before continuing. On the Scope page, choose the device groups you want to apply this IoC to. In this case, I'll select Check, Uncheck All to include all my device groups, and then review the summary and select Save. In the next segment, I'll demonstrate how to batch import these indicators, saving you a good bit of time. Many customers already have IoCs from other sources and can export them to a CSV file. In that case, you can easily import these files into Defender for Endpoint to batch create IoCs. To import indicators, you need to have certain information in your CSV file. So, select Download Sample CSV to get a sample that you can customize. Pretty simple structure. Notice that the expiration time on this one is blank. That means that it never expires. I used the sample to create my own file that shows each type of IoC that you can import into Microsoft Defender for Endpoint. Now I'm ready to import this. So select Choose File. Open the file, and then select Import. That's it. And, by the way, if you're constantly adding to this CSV file, you can always re-import it, and Defender for Endpoint will only add the new IoCs, rather than adding duplicates. Next, I'll show you how to add indicators from any entity page in Defender for Endpoint. Another way to add indicators in Microsoft 365 Defender is within the context of an entity. For example, Defender for Endpoint discovered this URL as part of an incident investigation. You can select Add Indicator right here, or select Open URL page to view the URL's entity page and do it there. In the future, I want to block this URL. And to do that, I select Add Indicator, which opens the same indicator creation wizard I showed you earlier. The URL is already there, so I just need to complete the wizard. This experience makes it easy to add IoCs during an investigation. Looking for something a bit more programmatic? Like an API, you can use the Defender for Endpoint APIs to push IoCs. Your app will need permission to read and write all IoCs. For more information, see the article titled "Access the Microsoft Defender for Endpoint APIs" in Microsoft Docs. The final method to add IoCs to Defender for Endpoint is through partner applications. This page contains the list of available partners with links to how to set them up. Defender for Endpoint provides multiple ways to add custom indicators of compromise. You can learn more about IOCs and Defender for Endpoint on Microsoft Docs. Microsoft Security.